Thanksgiving to Our Lady of Wilinkany. Birthday blessings for Oliver Simmons on his first birthday. Birthday blessings for Myro Simmons, Dahlia and Aniket Pereira. Well-being of Pope Francis, Cardinal Oswald, bishops, cardinals, priests, deacons, Fathers Ruben, Daniel, Christopher, Joe. Good health of Anthony, Frida, Andre, Kim and Alan. The well-being of Melissa. Good health of Ramilla, Gemma, Flora, Ramesh, Usha, Coraline. Good health and for jobs for Archie Dunbar and family. Thanksgiving for success in exams. For the souls of Mary Andrade, first death anniversary. Carmeline Thomas Gomes, first death anniversary. Clifford Cardo's month's mine. Thais DeMello, Dadi Jangir Mehta. Spencer D'Souza and Angeline Cabral, Anthony Agnes Visaukar, Joseph Montero, departed members of the staff and students of the Sacred Heart Boys School, Santa Cruz, batch of 1983, deceased members of the Coutinho and Fernandez families, Natty and Gilbert Falcon, Joachim Almeida and George Steed, Gilbert, Natty, Gilda Falcon, Mavis Kinney, Cayetano, Leslie and Lily, Joachim Lobo, Edna and Joe De Silva, deceased members of the Ferrao family, João Francisco Barreto and Consao Barreto, deceased members of the Quini family, Sebastiana Braganza, Raymond Pereira, Monica and William Tabora, Ian Jude De Souza, Maurice De Souza, Morgan De Souza, Sebastian Santos, Caroline Galvano, Aloysius and Martha Fonseca and John Peso. We also join those celebrating their birthdays and anniversaries and all those who have praise and thanksgiving to offer for the gifts they have received from God. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Gathered around the altar of the Lord to celebrate these mysteries of love. Let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord to pardon and forgive us. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. The Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Thanks for your great glory.
us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Wisdom is bright and does not grow dim. By those who love her, she is readily seen and found by those who look for her. Quick to anticipate those who desire her, she makes herself known to them. Watch for her early, and you will have no trouble. You will find her sitting at your gates. Even to think about her is understanding fully grown. Be on the alert for her, and anxiety will quickly leave you. She herself walks about, looking for those who are worthy of her, and graciously shows herself to them as they go. In every thought of theirs, she comes to meet them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The words of our response are, "For you my soul is thirsting, O God, my God." Kindly listen to the tune.
For you my soul is thirsting, O God, my God. For you my soul is thirsting, O God, my God.
O God, you are my God. For you I long. For you my soul is thirsting. My body pines for you like a dry, weary land without water. Together.
For you my soul is thirsting, O God, my God.
So I gaze on you in the sanctuary to see your strength and your glory. For your love is better than life. My lips will speak your praise. Together.
For you my soul is thirsting, O God, my God.
So I will bless you all my life. In your name I will lift up your hands. My soul shall be filled as with a banquet. My mouth shall praise you with joy. Together.
For you my soul is thirsting, O God, my God.
On my bed I remember you. On you I muse through the night, for you have been my help. In the shadow of your wings I rejoice. Together.
For you my soul is thirsting, O God, my God.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Thessalonians. We want you to be quite certain, brothers, about those who have died, to make sure that you do not grieve about them, like the other people who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and that it will be the same for all those who have died in Jesus. God will bring them with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Because you do not know the hour when the Son of Man is coming.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel. Matthew. Jesus told this parable to his disciples. The kingdom of heaven will be like this. 10 bridesmaids took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were sensible. The foolish ones did take their lamps, but they brought no oil. Whereas the sensible ones took flasks of oil as well as their lamps. The bridegroom was late, and they all grew drowsy and fell asleep. But at midnight there was a cry, "The bridegroom is here, go out and meet him." At this, all those bridesmaids woke up and trimmed their lamps, and the foolish one said to the sensible ones, "Give us some of your oil, our lamps are going out." But they replied, "There may not be enough for us and for you. You had better go to those who sell it and buy some for yourselves." They had gone off to buy it when the bridegroom arrived. Those who were ready went in with him to the wedding hall, and the door was closed. The other bridesmaids arrived later. "Lord, Lord," they said, "open the door for us." But he replied, "I tell you solemnly, I do not know you. So stay awake, because you do not know either the day or the hour." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I'm sure all of you, dear brothers and sisters, have had various experiences at weddings, whether it's the celebration of the religious part or even if it's the secular part. Sometimes there are celebrations before the wedding and also those that are after, where the entire family and friends get together and there is a lot of fun. In our own communities within our country, we know that there are different days allotted for different celebrations. And everyone participates in these celebrations in order to show the couple how special they are. And in fact, the very choice of us being part of the celebration means that the couple has shown us how special we are to them. In today's gospel, there is a parable told of a wedding. Now, by reading this parable, we realize that there are certain eschatological overtones. In other words, this is talking to us about the end times. And the readings during these last Sundays before we celebrate the season of Advent are giving us these various aspects of what the end times are. And the focus of today's gospel is a reminder to all of us to be alert and awake. Now, one thing is very clear. The Lord, while giving us this beautiful parable of the wedding feast, is trying to tell us that at the end time, when we meet our Lord, it is going to be an occasion of joy like a wedding is. And for that, we've got to be ready. And so in telling us about these 5 wise and 5 foolish bridesmaids, he gives us an opportunity to think about what is our preparation for this end time. And remember that when the Lord comes, it's not known. When we are going to face our Maker is not known. But we must be ready and prepared. And as we as little children always love to sing that hymn, "Give me oil in my lamp, keep me burning." This oil that we're talking about, that the Lord is speaking about, is the oil of joy that comes from worshipping the Lord, believing in Him, doing good deeds in His name, serving people, making a difference in the world. In other words, our preparation for the end is a joyful preparation, because we can invest in this lamp that is our lives all the possible oil that we can fill into the oil of love, the oil of peace, the oil of joy, the oil of good works. Because as we hear the Lord telling us, the door will be open to us when we celebrate life in His name. And for this, what is important is wisdom. How to fill those lamps with the oil that will burn throughout, burn with love for the Lord, burn with love for one another. And wisdom was a quality that we remember King Solomon also prayed for. And wisdom is very important because it helps us discern what is right and wrong. It helps us discern what is the best that we can do in our lives as Christians. And there are so many opportunities given to us. And St. Paul is telling the people of Thessalonica today that we must live life, and even if we have lost our loved ones, we must always remember that the loved ones are with God. God is the one who sent them into this world. God is the one who takes them back. And it is this God for whom our soul is thirsting. And the thirst that we have, once again, fills the oil, fills the lamp of our lives with this oil. And this thirsting comes therefore from our prayer. It comes from our reading of the word, comes from knowing God through our various actions and good deeds. In our families today, there are numerous opportunities for us to fill the lamp of our lives with that oil. Given the times of COVID, we know that families have been together, doing a lot of good things together. I also know that people possibly have been getting on one another's nerves, but that is obvious because we are human and we are weak. But we must remember that every family member is a blessing to us. We are blessings to them. And the more and more we fill the lamp of our lives with this joy, this service that we render to each other, the love that we show, the forgiveness, we are preparing ourselves so beautifully to meet the Lord. Whether it is in the community, whether it's in the parish, even if we are in this online participation of the Eucharist, the prayers that we make for each other are prayers that permeate every corner of the earth. And this is something that we must remember, that the joy that comes from praying for each other is a joy that fills the world. It also fills the lamps of our lives. And this is what the Lord is telling us in the Gospel today. Fill your lamps. Let them be burning. Burning with love. Burning with joy. So that when it comes to meeting the Lord, we won't have to look for that oil. The oil is there. We don't have to waste time running for that oil elsewhere. The oil is there. We don't waste time, because if we do, we will never be recognized as God's loved disciples, because we have been foolish. Foolish not to use the opportunities that He has given us. This is a parable that reminds you and me that God continues to love us, but we at the same time must be ready to accept that love and to fill the lamps of our lives with the oil of love. Amen. We profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We pray for wisdom and patience as we prepare for God's kingdom, surrendering our needs to Him for whom we long and thirst. Our response is, God of wisdom, hear our prayer. All together.
God of wisdom, hear our prayer.
That Pope Francis, the bishops, priests, and religious may encourage people to seek God's will in preparation for His kingdom of love, peace, and joy. We pray to the Lord.
God of wisdom, hear our prayer.
That the leaders of the world and those in authority may make decisions and plan policies for the benefit of all who are struggling for the basic necessities of life. We pray to the Lord.
God of wisdom, hear our prayer.
That every parishioner may wisely fill their lamps with love, unity and mercy as they grow together as one big family. We pray to the Lord.
God of wisdom, hear our prayer.
That we may all cooperate with each other as clergy, religious and the laity in shouldering the various responsibilities in our parish. We pray to the Lord.
God of wisdom, hear our prayer.
That all those infected by COVID-19 and those affected in different ways may find refuge in the Lord's healing strength. We pray to the Lord.
God of wisdom, hear our prayer.
That the Lord answers the prayers we now offer in silence. We pray to the Lord.
God of wisdom, hear our prayer. Lord our God, as we call upon you to help us, we thank you for listening to the prayers we have offered up into your presence. May you grant them according to your will, through your Son, Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Hosanna.
Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this
bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Osgood, our Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and save from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant you peace and unity in accordance with your will, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Our act of spiritual communion,
my Jesus,
I believe that you are present
in
the most holy sacrament.
I love you above all things,
and I desire to receive you
into my soul.
since I cannot at this moment,
since I cannot at this moment
receive you sacramentally,
receive you sacramentally,
come at least spiritually,
come at least spiritually
into my heart,
into my heart.
I embrace you as if you were already there,
as if you were already there,
and unite myself,
and unite myself
wholly to you,
wholly to you.
Never permit me to be separated from you.
To be separated from you.
Amen. Strengthen our faith and the faith of others. And as we pray for ourselves, we also lift up to you the many people around us who need your help the most. Those who are sick and depressed, those who are suffering, those in hospital, those who need your healing presence. Lord, we pray for those couples that are worried about their lives, their relationships. We pray that they may seek help and healing. We lift up to you the families that are fractured and broken. We pray for ourselves that in this journey that we make through life, we may always be nourished by the Eucharist and bring joy to the lives of others as you have willed it. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We have begun receiving Masses for the month of December. We're following the same procedure. You can either send us your intentions by the parish email ID, which is parishofficemcc@yahoo.com, or drop the intentions in the drop box outside the parish office. We request you to restrict the number of intentions to 2 per family, because there are many who would like their intentions to be offered. The last date will be the 25th of November, the last date for your registrations for the Masses for December. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may the blessings of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give me oil in my lamp, keep me burning. Give me oil.